up, BattleTech fans? It's time. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you from us here at Battlebound at the Eye of the Tiger studio right here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. We got a special Christmas unboxing for you today. We got our Alpha Strike box set in, and I'm super pumped to bust it open. Jeff, what do you think?
I have no clue what's in it, so...
He doesn't do Alpha Strike that much. He don't stay up. He don't know. He's not informed. So this, I already know what to expect for the most part. I've just never actually held them in my hand. But for him, it's a whole new experience. We've already got your old pal, Mr. Stabby. He's got his classic look back. He wanted to, you know, see he's got the red suit there for Christmas, and he's got his little pointy hat. Right. For Santa Claus, and it's even got the little, you know. So, yeah, he's coming down your chimney. You ready? Coming down the chimney.
Bubble wrap!
Yay, you can pop this.
All right, I love it.
Go bat shit. This...
That doesn't pop.
Yeah, it does. Was sent to us by our fine friends at Game Nerds. Thank you, Game Nerds. We'll put a link in the description. We'll throw that link up here on the screen for you. He can't pop the bubble wrap. That's why you got Mr. Stabby. Put him down on the table. There. Not quite as satisfying, but you still get to pop it. How do you feel about that? You better now?
No. Not really.
Oh, Christmas dishes. Someone's going to get coal in her socket tonight. Okay. All right. Immediately, I like the fact that it just slides right out. I didn't even have to do the usual new box shimmy and shake to do the Macarena to get it to come out of the... So the box art, okay, first of all, let's talk about this box art. Jeff, what do you think about that before we look at these guys? You got your Atlas there. Look, a Wraith.
Okay.
You got that's a Wraith. You got your Pouncer there.
Right.
Warhawk, you know, with his... Okay. You even got the flamer action going there against an Atlas, Timberwolf back there. You got your Archer, Warhammer, Locust, probably a Stinger Stinger up there, Fire Moth. I mean, pretty involved little cover here, and you got Jade Falcon Pouncer.
Oh, yeah, okay.
See?
Yay, Falcon.
Yeah. First thing out of the box, we got Chaos Theory by Mr. Brian Young. You know, we love the Swank Motron up here in the Eye of the Tiger studio, Daddy. He was the guy we played with. We didn't play with him, but we hung out with him down in Utah while we were playing with Topher. And he came down and hung out with us. We'll have him on the show at some point or other, folks. But glad to see he's being represented in this box. Shout out to you, my dog. All right. Next up, we got the cards, baby. We got the Mo cards. Do you like these? You've played with these a couple of times. What do you think of these?
I like them. I mean, with the pilots on them and pilot abilities, I think that's huge.
Now, this is cool. They have a battlefield support deck in here.
Well, I have no idea.
And they have rules right there.
All right.
For you to, you know, be able to use these sort of things. I've never actually used battlefield support rules myself, so it's one of those things that I'm not, like, really all that familiar with. But, I mean, we got some new cards. All right. I've been having a lot of fun with these, so I'll be looking very forward to seeing what's in there. Comes with another set of dice. Very cool. We'll get to the miniatures here in just a second. I know everybody wants the miniatures, but to me, we save that for last. What else do we got here? We got the primer. The rules primer.
Okay.
Nifty little cover there. See that stalker there in the background? Black Knight. That looks like a griffin. Of course, I could... No. That's a, what do you call it? Hellhound.
Because
it's got the Clan Wolf on it, I think.
Conjurer.
Yeah, and there's a Vapor Eagle down there is what that looks like to me.
Okay.
So, okay, we know what these are. These are things that give you, you know, a quick outlook. Now, here is the quick start rules.
All right.
Let's check a look, have a look at those. Very cool. So, it's just your basic rundown here. All right, I like the fact that they have quick start rules for Alpha Strike. Now, I know I'm going to get to the miniatures. I know I keep saying, I'll get to the miniatures, and you're like, but Tuck, get to the miniatures. I swear, they ain't going anywhere, folks. They will make their way back to the screen here in just a second. I am super excited about this-ish right here.
Okay.
These are the buildings that it comes with.
Oh,
these are buildings.
All right.
And see how what you do is you fold them? kind of like the ones that I downloaded off of Sarna some years ago. Here, hold that. I downloaded these off of these buildings off of Sarna some years ago that looked somewhat similar to these. And I've seen the pictures of people, you know, folding theirs and putting theirs together, and I've been super excited to look at all these buildings that they have here. Man, that is so cool, just the variants that they have and the details. And so you're already starting to get it over
well,
there, aren't
I'm,
you?
I mean, I'm just following the bends in the cardboard and figuring, okay. I mean, I still don't know.
Probably need some kind of Elmer's glue or Mod Podge or something like that unless it threads.
No. Okay. So it does. Those tab A into slot B kind of a thing, that goes there and that'll go there, so that gives you your box.
Slot, box. Jeff, this is a family show. I'll remind you.
Okay.
Keep it classy. I don't want to get another 18 plus flag on this video. It's Christmas.
All right, so obviously...
Yeah, you forgot to put those flaps in there.
Fold those down.
Okay, so you don't have to glue these together.
No, it's all... And... there we go.
Yeah, pretty much in there.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
So, easy enough.
Yeah, easy enough, I suppose. Here, let's get a quick picture of that. I'll throw this guy right on top, a Nova. Yeah, looks right. I like it. Jeff, what do you think?
Yeah.
And of course, we got all these, so we'll have plenty of time to go through them and mess around and build up all those later. But that'll be like a whole little city right there. That's a whole little urban area.
Oh, yeah.
You know, those buildings that we've been taking out with us on the road for so long, they're pretty tired at this point, folks.
Yeah.
They have served us faithfully for many years, but there comes a time. In the cycle of every building. Woo, feel that, will you? That is hard cardstock right there.
All right.
Your references.
Give me some good charts there.
Oh, man, check this out, Jeff.
Oh, see now this is what I like, because I never really know what the, you know, on Alpha Strike, the special abilities, it actually explains the special abilities, the Alpha Strike special abilities.
Sure. Well, I guess the ones that are within this box set, the ones that you will find.
Right.
In here,
so that
flip it over.
I mean,
yeah. See, it's double sided, so you have all this
basic charts there. But I mean,
well, you say basic, but it's hard cardstock. Like,
oh, well, yeah. I mean, that's solid. I mean,
that's like the same material that they make the box out of.
Right. Yeah. I mean, that.
Now look at this.
All good.
Look.
All right.
Trees.
Seasonal. If you're
into that sort of thing.
If you're into seasonal trees.
But yeah, it looks like they just stand up on their own.
Yeah, fall, winter.
You look, see how they have the little slots there and you insert them?
Right, yeah.
Yeah, it looks like you're just making, you know, trees to put on your battlefield at home. So your kitchen table now becomes a battlefield instantly. And you have your objective markers here with more trees just in case you need them. Markers, just in case you want those, all provided free there. This is what they look like on the back. Now that is pretty freaking sweet. Gosh, that is so cool. I've told people for so long that you can just make your kitchen table into a battlefield. You don't have to have a bunch of expensive terrain or anything like that.
Not anymore.
No, you can just take, you know, bowls and cups and things like that, and that can be your terrain. That's a smokestack, and that's a sensor dome, and if you just use your imagination, you can go nuts. But now they have trees, and you can just cut a template out of paper and put the trees on top of it, and now you've got tree templates. Like, this game is almost... Actually, no, not almost. This game is literally playable right out of the box.
Yeah, you don't. I mean,
I guess the only thing you would need. Let me redact that. Is a measuring tape. But I don't know how they would include that.
Right.
In such a box, right. Unless they had a thing like this, where it had like a measuring stick on it.
Oh,
that
yeah,
went
they,
you know
right.
so many inches.
They could do that. Yeah. So. Yeah.
That's just an idea for the future. So before we get to the miniatures, box contents, Jeff, what do you think? Out of 10?
It definitely a strong 9. I don't think anything's missing. I think it's...
What would it take for this to be a 10? You say things like that, I gotta know now. Well, what would this take?
I guess the one missing element is a measuring tape.
Just something that could be used as a measuring tape.
Right. That has inches.
But I love the inclusion of the battlefield support deck. I think that is super cool. I can't wait to crack into this. Maybe do some kind of video tutorial on this about how to use them once we figure it out.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I've
because I think this would be neat because this includes things like artillery and just extra stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
So that'll be something interesting to explore.
All right.
And then, of course, we got all the new cards for all the stuff that comes in here. So... All right, the minis. It comes with 13 of these guys. So what do we got here? We got ourselves, looks like an Atlas, a Warhawk, a Warhammer, another Archer. This is a different Archer, though. It's got the lasers on the arms. That might be the legendary, Jamie Wolf's Archer. Timberwolf, Phoenix Hawk there. Looks like, there's the Wraith, Locust. There's the Pouncer, Moth. Blackjack. Looks like a stinger or a wasp. Maybe a Valkyrie. I'm not sure. I'll have to handle it. Then there's the Nova.
So everything that was on that artwork...
Yeah, is here in the box. Now, some of this stuff is reposed. So you'll take a mech like, for example, this Warhammer here. It's just a slightly different pose than, what it was in before.
Okay.
All right. What do you think?
Looks like this is the variant with the SRM-6, so that means it has the papier-mâché armor, which I freaking hate. I prefer my Warhammers without the SRM-6.
Jeff just had to get his shit in, didn't you? It's Wrong. Christmas. You're like, oh, wait a minute, hold on. I can't go a video without talking trash about the old basic Warhammer and how it isn't the Pillow Fort WHM-6D.
It's the 6R, so...
Give me that.
You asked. I'm
you uncultured swine.
You asked. I don't like the 6R.
Look at the Archer. All right. See how it's got the lasers on the arms
on
there?
On the arms, right. Okay, that's solid.
That's what makes me think.
Right. See, that's cool. I like that.
All right. On to the next.
All right, so...
Warhawk next, it looks like.
Yeah, we'll go back this direction over here.
What's your favorite variant of the Warhawk, Jeff? Is it the Warhawk Z?
It is not the Warhawk Z, no.
Aw, why you gotta be such a party pooper?
Way too many times I've run...
Does that have the missile rack on it? Let me see this.
Way too many times I've run into a C. That thing is...
Hold on, look, Jeff, I'm not seeing a missile rack on this.
The 10 rack?
Yeah, normally a Warhawk Prime would have a missile rack.
So maybe it is a C?
Maybe.
I mean, you'd probably know that if you looked at the cards. I'm sure the cards would tell
Atlas.
You.
Atlas. We got an Atlas. Different pose. He's standing there very stalwart. And here is a side-by-side of one that I painted and the new one. Can you see the difference now? How they have a slightly different pose there?
Right, okay.
You can see it in the arms mainly.
Oh, yeah. The arms are down.
The feet are in different positions there.
Right.
One there, the right foot is up front, whereas in this one, the right foot is a little bit farther behind.
Oh, right. But beyond that, it looks like the same. I mean, the body, the torso, and head is all the same.
But still, I mean, I think it looks good. I'm all for reposes.
All right. Looks like your standard Prime. Hey, how about that? I can actually tell differences in Mad Cats.
Yeah, maybe I'm starting to work on you. He looks good. And what we go, A?
Yeah.
Phoenix Hawk. One of the main reasons I wanted this box set. Let's just be honest with ourselves here. The TR-1 Wraith, baby!
That's a solid mag.
Oh! It looks okay! He's got this big old gun, and he's taking a big old step. He's like, hey! Oh, that is so sweet. And look at the jump jets there in the back.
Yeah,
They're layered up. So you got your seven jump jets, three, six, seven right there.
Right.
It's so creative. I love it.
Oh, yeah, okay.
See, he's got that bug face.
Right there.
Yep. Oh, that is so great. That is perfect. I love the jump jets.
Yeah, those are solid.
Aw, yes.
So, was that a large pulse laser?
Yep, large pulse and two medium pulses.
Two medium pulses over there.
Yep, TR1.
Definitely one of my favorites of Inner Sphere.
Well, so I guess if we are going to jump into the resculpts, or not resculpts, I should say, the new scene versions of things that I've been dying to see out of this box set, let's talk about the Pouncer, because, oh my god, I can't tell you how excited I am that this is finally in plastic, because I absolutely hate assembling them in metal. I love this hobby. And anyway, it looks great. Yeah. Y'all squat.
So, five jump jets. So,
I don't remember what the heck this thing's profile is. I know there's a couple of them. Get the top. Let me see the top. Yeah, see, it's got all that detail. Very, very cool.
That looks like, twin PPCs?
I believe so. I'd have to look it up off the top of my head.
Right.
Now we've got our Locust repose. Nice looking little Locust there. He looks ready for action, don't you think? Hi, my name is Duke Nukem. Look at that. Alright, oops. Now we got ourselves a Fire Moth. The Dasha. I like how it doesn't have a little butt plate back here anymore. How it used to, but it doesn't now. What do you think? There's your Dasher D. Whee!
Is it the D?
No, I know. I mean, it looks like it because it has the lasers on top there.
Right.
And normally those would be missile packs if that was a Dasher Prime.
So I think
it probably is.
Probably is the D. The only playable Dasher that would be.
Aw, come on.
I mean, if you're...
Why you gotta hate?
If you're gonna be in a Dasher...
Why you hate him? You that plebe hating on a Dasher. How dare you? I have several questions. First of all, how dare you? Lancelot.
Oh, Lancelot's cool.
No, not a Lancelot. This is a Blackjack.
Oh, okay.
It just looked like a Lancelot because I was looking at it from a different angle.
GM's okayest products.
I think it looks great. I love the little holes on the barrel there. The vents on the legs look fantastic. I wonder if this is the BJ20 or if it's like a standard Blackjack or what. Alright, we'll go A. And looks like we got us a Wasp. Z-Wasp. Looking decent. And then we got ourselves a Nova. Looks like a Prime to me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
Six lasers per side.
Yeah.
So probably just a different pose. Well, Jeff, that brings us to the end of our little Christmas adventure here. What do you think about what you're looking at? You're my favorite everyman on the street opinion. So what do you think but for what you're looking at? Now, remember, the MSRP on this box is something like $80. It's $79.99.
Oh, wow.
So now you've seen what you get. Now, Game Nerds, they got this to me for, you know, not quite that much. I won't say how much, but not quite that much. So thank you to them. But again, for if you were to pay MSRP, how would you feel about it?
$80.
And you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 miniatures.
13 minis. I mean that's pretty good for
eight. Plus all the buildings, the papercraft buildings.
All the buildings, all the counters, the trees. I mean,
yep.
I mean, everything to turn your tabletop into a battlefield.
Into a war zone, except for a measuring tape.
A measuring tape.
And a dry erase marker of some kind to write on the Alpha Strike cards with. Though
right.
I would recommend getting some card sleeves, because if you leave that stuff on there too long, it's on there permanently and you can't get it off.
Right.
So that's for $80 out of 5 stars, 1 being terrible, not worth your money, 5 being absolute, this is a buy, where do you put this at?
I would give it a 5. It looks everything you need for an instant fight, and you have the info on the individual units here, so you're all good to go to just drop it onto a table and go for it.
Yeah, so. I mean, the price is a little steep, but for what you get, I mean, I'm gonna say, yeah, this is good. This is 5. Again, the price is steep, but again, it's a great value. I can't knock it. I can't say anything bad about it. I like that. I love the Wraith. I love this stuff. I love the fact that they gave us the plastic pouncer. No more! Ever! So, I'm happy with it. You know, I'm completely satisfied with the purchase. I'm very excited to start painting some of these guys. If this were, you know, somebody who was looking to get into Alpha Strike, the game, not as looking at this from a collector standpoint like you and I sometimes tend to. If this were something that somebody was trying to say, hey, I can get you into this right now, you know, if you pick this box up, we can start going right this minute at this game store, would that be something you would be willing to shell out for if you were like, I like Battletech?
Definitely. If I wanted to learn Alpha Strike, I got my rules here, so... Got my rules, got my figs. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I say it's a complete box, you know, system in a box.
Right.
Yeah, everything. And that's one of the things I've always loved about Battletech, folks, is it's always got the everything you need right there. And again, like I say, I think aside from tape measures, which I'm not going to fault them for. I'm not going to ding them for that.
No.
I'm not going to ding them for not having a permanent or a dry erase marker in there. I'm not going to do that. So I feel like, you know, this is right out of the box. If you have those couple of items, you should be good to go. So all around, high fives.
Yep.
Yep, very good. Folks, like I say, thank you so much for joining us here on this Christmas unboxing. We had the Alpha Strike box set. We'll catch you folks next time out on the space lane.
Be sure to smash our like button and subscribe to our channel.
Crowdfunding is when lots of people give you small amounts of money to help your passion project come to life.